Hi, in this aspect of chemistry, we shall be discussing about the atomic structure. The atomic structure is talking about how atom is made, what comprises atom, and what are the different components of atom. Scientists talked about different components of atoms, and how do we study, do we gain the knowledge from all these scientists. Okay, so here we have that an atom was described as the smallest unit of a chemical element that can exist. An atom is the smallest unit of a chemical element that can exist. The Greek word for atom is atomos. The Greek word for atom is atomos, meaning not divisible. Atomos, meaning not divisible. Okay, an atom is the smallest indivisible part of an element. The study of an atom gave birth to different models and theory, some which are described below. Now, some scientists single-handedly deep search the knowledge of atom, and they were able to come with different postulations. These scientists are what we want to look at first. Now, number one person who discusses the existence of atom is Dalton, and we call it Dalton atomic theory. John Dalton in 1808 put forward the atomic theory, which are all elements are made up of smaller indivisible particles called atoms. Okay, one of the model of Dalton was that he gave a postulation that all elements are made up of small indivisible particles called atom. Atom can neither be created nor destroyed. He was trying to discuss more about the atom. Atom of the same element are exactly alike. He was still talking about the same aspect, the same atom, and what constitutes this atom. Now, when atom combine, they do so in simple ratios. When atom combine, they do so in simple ratios. With his knowledge of atom, he was able to coin that. He was able to deduce that when atom combine, they do so in simple ratios. Now, the fifth model was all chemical reactions occur by the combination or separation of atoms. All chemical reactions occur by the combination or separation of atoms. Now, but with this postulation, not all the postulation can be generally accepted. By this, there is modification for Dalton's atomic theory. And one of the modifications is experiment shows that atom is divisible, consisting of what? Proton, neutron, and electron. Atom is divisible, consisting of proton, neutron, and what's now electron. So it is not indivisible. Now, atoms can be created and destroyed, particularly during nuclear reactions. Atom can be created and destroyed, particularly nuclear reaction. This is in contrary to what Dalton said by saying atom can neither be created nor destroyed. Obviously, atom can be created and destroyed during what's now nuclear reaction. Atoms of elements are not exactly alike. Atoms of elements are not exactly alike. And this is in contrary to what Dalton said by saying atoms of the same element are exactly alike. Now, this can be seen in isotope. Isotope is just the existence of atom of the same atomic number but different mass number. Okay, now this is seen here. That's why we wrote this. Now, hydrogen has different isotopes. We have protium with mass number of 1, we have deuterium with mass number of 2, we have tritium with mass number of what now? 3. And with this now, it means it's still the same hydrogen. So they are not exactly alike because their mass number is different. They only have the same what now? Atomic number. And this is what we know as what an isotope. Now, number 4, most reactions occur in large fraction. As seen in nuclear reaction occurs in large fraction, and so this is in contrary to what is when atom combine, they do so in simple ratios. Now again, the second person who talks about the theory of atoms is Bohr. So Niels Bohr, we call it Bohr's atomic theory. Niels Bohr puts forward the theory of an atom, which is based on the quantum theory. The quantum theory is talking about different energy level, and because of that, he was able to discuss that in an atom, the three parts or particles of an atom, which are the proton, the neutron, and the electron, he was trying to discuss that the electron, it was revolving around the nucleus of an atom, and with, of which the proton and the neutron is embedded inside the nucleus. Okay, now the next scientist was J.J. Thomson. He is considered to be the discoverer of the electron using an experiment termed Plumpudding. A Plumpudding experiment is an experiment with which a negative plumb, it was revolving around a positive atmosphere. A negative plumb was revolving around the what's now a positive atmosphere. Now, for the fourth scientist was Lord Ernest Rutherford. Rutherford stated that the atom consists of a centrally dense core called nucleus. He said that the atom consists of a centrally dense core called what's now the nucleus, of which what I said earlier was that inside the nucleus there is a what's now proton and neutron. So these are usually called, where you can see proton, you can also see neutron, and the two are inside the what's now the nucleus. Outside the nucleus is where you find the what's now your electrons revolving around it, and that is in accordance to what Bohr said concerning what's now quantum theory. Okay, number five, we have the time. He determined the charge on an electron using the oil drop experiment. Electron is positively charged. So this, electron is negatively charged. So this charge was discovered by Harry Millikan using the what's now the oil drop experiment. Now let's look at the structure of an atom in food. This is the structure of an atom. This is called the orbit. The orbit where electrons are found. Now inside the orbit, at the orbit, you see an electron revolving around it. Now inside the atom, there is a dense core called what's now the nucleus, and inside there is a dense core called the nucleus. So where you can see the neutron and the what's now the proton. Now comparing these properties, the location, the charge, and the mass. The proton is in the nucleus, and the charge is positive. It has a mass of 1. The neutron is also in the nucleus. It is what's now. Does not have a charge, and its mass also 1. The electron is revolving around the orbit, and the charge is negative. Its mass is 1/1840. Now let's discuss about the atomic number. When we look at our element in the periodic table, there's something we discuss there in the periodic table concerning the atomic number, the mass number, the proton number, and the neutron number. Now, for every individual element has an atomic number and a mass number. For every element, they have atomic number and what's now the mass number. So, atomic number is the number of proton present in the atom of an electron. For a neutral atom, the number of proton equals the number of what's now electron. That's the number for a neutral atom. For a neutral atom, the number of proton is equal to the number of electron. But this is as a result of neutral atom. But when an electron is charged, this is opposite. When an electron is charged, this condition does not hold effect, because this time around, the electron is being lost or gained. But for an atom, when it is neutral, then the number of proton equals the number of what's now electrons. Now for the mass number, this is the sum of the atomic number and the what's now the proton number. It is also known as the nuclear number. So this is a representation of our element. We represent our element with X, symbol of our element. Then the number up is the mass number, while the number down, which is referred to as the subscript, is the atomic number. So the representation for a mass number is A, the representation for an atomic number is Z, while the representation for a neutron number is N. So the addition of the Z plus N, which are the atomic number and the neutron number, gives the mass number A. Now, we have a kind of illustration here to be able to get to be able to understand what and what constitute the proton number, the neutron number, the electron number, the neutron number in a particular element. So here we are to calculate the atomic number, mass number, the neutron number, the proton number, electron number of the atom represented below. So we have a calcium, we have a calcium atom, we have a hydrogen atom, we have a sodium atom. Now for calcium, the number up is already mass number, so it is 40. The number down is an atomic number, so it is 20. Now the proton, it is the number of the proton number is still the same as the what's now the atomic number, because atomic number is the number of proton. So that is why this proton is still be 20. Now this is a neutral number because there is no charge. This is a neutral atom. There is no charge. The calcium is not carrying any charge. So for a neutral atom, the number of proton equals the number of electrons. That's why the electron is what's now 20 here. So for us to get the neutral number, we need to do a few mathematics here by what now subtracting the atomic number from the mass number. So we have 40 minus 20. So the neutral number is what now 20. Now for hydrogen atom, the hydrogen atom has a mass number of 1. The atomic number has a mass number of 1 also. The atomic number, is number down, while the mass number is the number up. Then the proton number is still the number of atomic number. So that's C1, because atomic number is the number of proton in the atom. So when atomic number is 1, obviously the proton is also going to be 1. Now the electron, because the hydrogen is a neutral atom, it's not carrying any charge. So the number of proton equals the number of electron. That's why this is 1. So with few mathematics, we can get the neutral number by subtracting the atomic number from the what's the mass number. So we subtract 1 from 1, then we are going to get 0. Now for the sodium atom, will have a mass number of 23, the atomic number of 11, the proton number is also 1 because the atomic number is 11. The proton number is 11 because the atomic number is 11, and this is as a result of the atomic number being the number of proton in an atom. So when the atomic number is 11, the proton number is also going to be 11. The electron number is also 11 because in a neutral atom the number of proton equals the number of electron. Now for neutron, we do some mathematics by subtracting the atomic number from the what's now the mass number. So we have 23 minus 11, and that's what 12. Now I think we are through with this aspect of class. We've written everything in a manner or aspect with which we are going to follow as we are explaining. So we hope you enjoy the short video. Thank you so much.